Hello and welcome to another Audacious Fashion Studio tutorial. On this tutorial, you're gonna learn how to make a puffer jacket. So let's get started. I'll go to File, New, and for this one, I'm going to select the male 22. As you see, it automatically creates a mesh all over the avatar's body. So the first thing we want to do is to cut the edges of our piece. So with Cut with Ring tool, I will cut the edges. I'll cut the bottom part and I'll also create another line to make the elastic. And I want to increase the length of the sleeves, so I'm going to expand borders with Ctrl pressed. I will select, once it's yellow it's because it's ready to edit, and pressing shift I will select the other cuff as well, so it makes on both sides, and I speed it up. As you see, it grows. Once it looks good, I can stop. Now I'll go to cut with ring. I will press Y on my keyboard, so it enables the symmetry plane, so you see everything I make on one side replicates to the other, and I will cut right on the edge of the body. If I want to see the body underneath the mesh, I can press W on my keyboard, or you can also press down here, as you can see, so you see the wireframe mode, and cut. Alright, now I press L to select, or you can go to this tool over here. Let's press W again, so it returns to the mesh format. And I will select both parts and delete, because I do not want that extra part. Now I'm going to make the same thing I did on cuffs here on the neckline, because I want it to be a high color. So I'm going to expand border, select pressing Ctrl, and I will speed it up. Now with cut with ring, I will press Ctrl and twist it just a little bit, and it looks good over here. Left mouse button, let's remove the wireframe mode with W. I can check if it looks good. Yes, I can click on right mouse button to make the cut. Now press L to select this part and delete. Alright, so now the next thing I'm gonna do is make the central cut where the zipper goes. So I will cut with ring, I will twist it to the top part because the yellow circle is the one that cuts, okay? And I will roll the scroll on my mouse to make the ring bigger. Left mouse button, right mouse button, and the cut is done. Now this cut over here I don't want, so I remove it pressing remove cuts, and I don't want this on the back as well, and I will just click and it removes the cut. I don't want this one here as well, so I'm going to remove that. Alright, so the part that's gonna be puffer is both this part and the back. So I'm going to select only these two parts. Now with cut with ring, I will make the cuts of my puffer jacket. So let's make it about here. Left mouse button, right mouse button to confirm. Left mouse button, right mouse button to confirm. Oh, I forgot to make the armholes, so I will enable the symmetry plane, make the ring bigger, and I will twist it just a little bit. I can make it with the pressing Ctrl and moving the scroll of the mouse, I zoom in and zoom out so I can see it, and pressing Ctrl and the left mouse button, I can also twist the 3D model, as you can see, so I can visualize as I want, zoom out, zoom in. Alright, the cut is okay, it looks good, and I will confirm with the right mouse button. Now it's green, so the cut is done. As you see, if I want to delete it, I can delete it, but I do not want to delete this one. Now I'm going to select the sleeves, both sleeves, cut with ring. As you see, the symmetry plan is enabled, pressing Y, so everything I make here is made on the other sleeve as well. Left mouse button, right mouse button, left mouse button, right mouse button, left mouse button, right mouse button, and the cuts are done. I feel like it's missing another one on the top. Well, maybe not. I'll leave it like that. If I enable the edit mode, I can see how it looks so far. Now let's get to the fun part. We are going to inflate it. So we're going to select all parts that we want to inflate. I will remove the symmetry plan here because I've tested it before and it's better when it's not on. Now I have all parts that I want to inflate. I'll go to simulate, and on inflation I'm going to inflate. Oops, I forgot to pin the borders. You want to pin borders, so check this box on top so the seams remain on place. So you go to inflate and inflate it just as much as you want. If you keep pressing inflation, it's gonna be like really inflated. That's not what I want, so I'm just a little bit. Maybe it went too much. Let's start over. Oh, what did I do? Alright. Maybe it looks too inflated. So I will select the parts that I don't want too inflated. Like this one and this one. And I'm going to go to smooth and smooth it a little bit. I can make it with more strength so it makes more smooth, and smooth it out. And also on the front here, I want to smooth it a little bit. All done. We basically have already our puffer jacket. Now we are going to apply a zipper on these front seams. So with control selected, with control pressed, I'm going to select the seams that I want to apply the zipper. Press shift to select all the lines that goes zipper. As you see, the line is yellow, so you have it ready. And I'm going to application, seam and zipper, and I will apply a zipper of my choice. So I'm going to apply this zipper big and full. And over here I can change the colors, change the size, the spacing of my zipper, as you see, to one side or another. I will put it just on top. And let's make it maybe gray. Okay. So as you see, our puffer jacket is ready. Now let's remove this mannequin, and I want also to remove the bottom part, so we leave just the jacket. Now I'm gonna show you how to apply different colors, prints, and texture to your jacket. So we're going to select the whole jacket, and here on color you can choose whatever color you want. Let's make this this green color, and I want to apply a different texture, so I can select from the library, or you can also import a normal map using of your folder. So I'm going to use the library, and I choose the normal map, this letter normal map, and apply. And it applies, and I can resize it. As you see, the texture is there. I can resize it and twist it just as I want. I think this color is not a good choice for letter, right? Let's make it black. Over here, I can also make it shinier or less shiny. Over here, you can also work on transparency, but nobody wants a transparent puffer jacket, right? And here we have our first colorway. Let's create another colorway. So I'm going to select this button over here, and it's gonna create another new variant that I can change. So let's make this a pink one, and also select another texture, shall we? And for this one, I'm gonna just test how it works if I select the wool texture, and I will resize it so it looks more like a knit, something like that, or a jersey, something. Let's create another variant, click in here, and to apply, for example, a pattern, you go to application, fabric, pattern, and you can select from your library whatever pattern you want. So for this one, I'm going to select this. And as you can see, the check is uneven on each part, so you can go and select, clicking with L, and then select the parts that you want to edit. And you can resize it so it looks the same on all parts. So if you want a bigger one, let's select the ones that are small here. I will enable the symmetry plan, clicking Y, and I will select all parts that I want to resize it. And now I'm gonna go here to resize it and make it bigger. Let's see how it looks. Yes, now I want this one to be a little bit smaller. This lower part as well. And it looks good. Now we can create another variant, clicking over here again. I will remove this pattern and select a new one. Let's see with this option over here. Cool. You can resize it all at once or each part. I think this one looks pretty even. We have another variant there. Let's see another one. I will remove the print and apply a new one. Let's see this one over here, or this one better. Let's resize it all at once. Looks good. So that's it. We have four variants that we made pretty quickly. As you can see, actually we have five variants. Now free your imagination and create by yourself and have fun. I'll see you next time. Bye bye.